Hi there guys, Tom Quayle here for Guitar Interactive Magazine, back again with another review. This time, as you can see, with one damaged arm. So I've got to say, first of all, thank you to Dan Smith, my good mate, for playing so wonderfully in the intro to this particular review. I can't play at the moment, unfortunately, but I can speak, so I can talk to you about these guitars. Now, these are very, very interesting. As you can see, this is a Taylor. And this is actually the Taylor Academy series, and what I've got here is the Taylor Academy 10E. Now, they do a 10, a 10E, a 12, and a 12E, and then a 12EN Academy series, which is the nylon string version. We've got two versions here, and these are both steel strings. This is the 10E, this is the Dreadnought version, and shortly I will show you the 12E, which is the sort of grand auditorium style guitar. And these are very interesting because these are basically Taylor's version of a starter guitar. Now, a Taylor starter guitar is quite something. You don't think of somebody owning a Taylor as their first guitar, but these are very, very useful in that range in terms of somebody getting a really good starter guitar. Now, the guys at Taylor decided that effectively when people buy their first guitar, the biggest struggle they often have is that the guitar is really hard to play, doesn't sound very good, doesn't look very good. It's not very inspiring because we go out and we spend £100 on a really poor acoustic or electric and it just doesn't play that well. Well, these, the Academy series, are designed to be fairly cost effective, or as cost effective as you can get for a guitar of this quality. They're made in Mexico, so that helps to keep the cost down as well. But they're very, very high quality with some very cool features for starter guitars. So, as usual, let's start up at the headstock end, work our way down and see what we've got. So, up at the headstock, we've got the three per side standard Taylor headstock, really, really nice. We've got a mahogany neck with a real ebony fretboard, which is pretty impressive. And straight away, using just my right hand, excuse my lack of left hand operation here, it's a fractured elbow, we've got incredible fretwork. Really, really impressive on a 24 7/8 inch scale length. So it's a very, very comfortable scale length. Very, very comfortable neck. Unfinished here in terms of there's no gloss on here or anything. It's just a satin finish, an oiled finish. And boy, does it feel comfortable. Really, really nice indeed. Very comfortable C profile. Really, really well made. And again, we've just got basic things going on here. Just little dot inlays, but very pretty. They look very nice indeed. Then as we come up to the actual body, joining at the 14th fret, and what we've got here is a Sitka spruce top and a layered Sapel back and sides construction. Okay, now if we turn this over, you can see on the side there, really, really nice kind of finish on the grain. Very, very nice. Sapel's kind of like a mahogany equivalent, but a cheaper version. And it looks great. You've got no kind of qualms here as far as how the guitar looks. It's a really, really good looking guitar. We've got a nice kind of rope style rosette on there. And very impressively indeed, we've also got a mahogany armrest on here. Now these are made from basically neck cuttings that are being thrown away in the factory, and they make the armrest. Now, to have an armrest on a guitar at this price for a starter guitar is absolutely incredible, and it really does the job. And you tend to only find those on super high-end Taylors, super high-end kind of acoustic guitars within the market. So to have one on a starter guitar, and again, it enhances the playability and comfort of the instrument. Very, very impressive indeed. Now, even further, to make this guitar even more impressive, we've got an expression system built in here as well. So on the top here, it's a very basic setup. We've got a basic tuner and then volume and tone, and then just a standard kind of battery compartment on here as well. Nothing too sort of flash, but man, does it sound good. You heard when Dan was playing at the beginning, it's a very dynamic, very natural acoustic sound. So it really, really works very nicely. I'll just really quickly, with just my right hand, I'm afraid, demonstrate this for you. So the just plug straight in with the volume straight up and the tone all the way up as well, we get this sound. Very, very natural acoustic sound. Good dynamic. Represented very nicely indeed. If we roll the tone control down about halfway, and then all the way off. Very musical throughout the range, very, very cool indeed. Nothing too crazy going on here. Again, just a nice tuner in there as well. So absolutely great guitars. And the price of these, with the gig bag as well, a nice padded gig bag, you can't really go wrong. I could see Taylor selling a lot of these to guitar players who are certainly not beginners. I mean, I'm very tempted myself by one of these, especially this Dreadnought, which for me is really the best sounding one that we've reviewed. Fantastic sounding guitar, not a lot of money, really good construction, superb playability, and amazing sound, really. So very impressive indeed. So let's switch over now to the A12E with the expression system in. Of course, if you just buy the A12 or the A10, there's no expression system built in, so you need to mic it up, but we've got the expression versions here. So let's do that now, switch over to the A12, and I'll just show you really quickly the variation between the two models. All right, guys, so here's the A12E, and or the, I shouldn't say the A12, actually, because it's the Academy 12E rather than A12E. So the Academy 12E and the Academy 10E. The Academy 12E, as you can see, is a smaller body design, like a grand auditorium, if I can put my teeth back in, style design. Again, all the same features. So we've got a Sitka spruce top, Sapel back and sides, ebony fretboard, mahogany neck, so on and so forth. Everything you'd expect. You know, that you had on the Academy 10. And this guitar also has the expression system built in, the same rosette, all the same designs. It's also got the mahogany armrest as well, which is very, very cool. This one is a little bit more comfortable because of the body shape being the way it is. It does sound quite different. It's got a less pronounced mid-range and a slightly smaller sound, as you'd expect. Kind of, again, difficult for me to demonstrate, but if you go and check Dan's playthrough at the beginning, you'll see exactly how different they sound. But again, we've just got the standard volume and tone control. So with the tone control all the way up, nice bright sound. Again, you'll hear the mid-range is slightly less kind of full on this guitar. It's a different kind of sound. As we roll the tone control down, and then all the way off. Both guitars have really great sustain, really, really good tone. Certainly not what you'd expect for a starter guitar. So Taylor really raising the bar here to a level that I've not seen with starter guitars at all, or a guitar that's aimed at starters. So very impressive indeed. Again, very comfortable, same scale length, just plays great, sounds great, looks great. Everything in the package that you want. I think they're gonna sell a lot of these guitars to you know, guys looking for a kind of inexpensive, small-bodied acoustic guitar that's very comfortable to play and sounds great. So there you go, guys. That's the Taylor Academy series. As usual, check out the text in the magazine for further details. Thanks again to Dan Smith for doing our playthrough at the beginning. My name's Tom Quayle, and I will see you next time.